In today's video, we are turning Jack Hughes into the greatest player of all. Okay, goddammit. This could be a series, this could be one episode, but Jack Hughes is going to be the best player in the NHL by the time this series is over. This is one big problem the New Jersey Devils have, is we don't really have a goalie, and we're going to keep this like semi-realistic, you know, not too nerdy, but not too like... just stick on the ice. On the blue line, though, we got some absolute studs. Dougie Hamilton, our best player probably other than Jack Hughes. Luke Hughes, Jack Hughes' brother, is also an elite offensive defenseman. And Simone Nemec on the blue line. That is a stacked decor. I didn't even mention Siegenthaler because he's not like that superstar like highlight reel defenseman, but he's insane as well. Then you got Timo Meier, the big pickup for the New Jersey Devils. You got Dawson Mercer, Alex Holt. So we got three incredible right wingers. On the left, we have Jesper Bratt. I mean, Jack Hughes, right hand man. This kid is nasty. And he's going to be incredible for us. And then obviously at center, we have Jack Hughes, but we also have our captain and our second line center of the future, Nico Hischier. So we pick this up in the offseason of 2024. Here's the draft lottery, and we have the 8th pick, which the Devils could have in real life. Got no real clue. Well, let's see how this draft goes. I mean, is there a chance to move up? No, so I think we're just going to stay at our pick, and here is your top 7. Macklin Celebrini going at the Seattle Kraken. I know I end so many franchises, shut up. The first move we're gonna do to help Jack Hughes is draft this defensive defenseman Hagos, who's NHL ready. I think that's a perfect pick, and he is a 77 overall, medium elite. We didn't have a second round pick, but we have 2 third round picks, and I saw a gem somewhere here. Yeah, Ryerson Leanders. I mean, this guy's a real player. He's a 64 starter. That works. And oh my god, the guy we wanted got drafted. So we got the re-sign phase. We actually got rid of so many players. I think we released like 15 players, so we got a whole new roster to pick up for next year. But we got our coach back. We got Michael McLeod, we got Dawson Mercer, we got Schmidt, and we got our rookie. Our first move to help Jack Hughes out is get a coach that fits him perfectly. And I mean, this guy's not the best coach by any means, but he fits Jack Hughes pretty well. So we're just going to offer him the max we can offer him. We have 2 massive extensions to hand out here. Luke Hughes getting the first big extension for 6 years, and then Alexander Holtz also getting a 6-year extension. I'm gonna be trading Jake Allen here to the Edmonton Oilers, and you might be like, why would you trade Jake Allen? He's probably a pretty good goalie. But if we go into free agency, I feel like Cam Talbot is the perfect fit for this team. Think I found the 2 free agents we need. I think we're going to go Cam Talbot here for $5 million. I think that's going to be our first offer. And then to help out Jack Hughes on the power play and stuff, we're going to go for Max Pacioretty here. We're going to go 6.3 maybe. I feel like that should leave us enough for AHL players. Okay, we're going to start finding out if people accept stuff. So we got our head coach. That's perfect. I don't think patches will fit, but it's fine. He should be good on like the power play and stuff, and he's 86 overall. So we get Holtz, Hughes, Talbot, and Max Pacioretty. What a offseason. Season 1, Pacioretty, Hughes, Brad, Holtz, Hischier, Meier, one of the best top sixes in the league. Dawson Mercer on the third line. Then we got Siegenthaler, Hamilton, Hughes, Nemec, Marino, Micah traded because we don't need that. And then Hagos. And then in net, we have Cam Talbot and Schmidt. And then here's our power play. Pretty sick. This quote-unquote series is going to work, right? So we're going to simulate the entire regular season. And then if we make the playoffs, we're going to do this where we jump into games, sim the first 2 periods. And if we are up, I can play it. But if we're down or tied, I can't play. I just have to sim unless it goes to overtime. If we make the playoffs, then like the season ends when we lose in the playoffs, right? But if we don't make the playoffs and we're like down here, we keep simulating another season until we make the playoffs, kind of. So the next episode will start if we lose in the playoffs and we don't win the Stanley Cup. You know what I mean? That hopefully that makes sense. First big injury, Simone Nemec. He's not out for that long. But, I mean, that's a big loss. The rookie and Hughes, I wonder how they were playing. But we're going to put Kevin Ball up there. It's not a minus one, that's cap. And then we can move Marino. Oh, Nemec is back already. I mean, yeah, see, it's not even that low. And here we go, Nemec. Nemec and Hughes, they're playing pretty well. Jack Hughes, the star of the show, is injured. I mean, this is like a Devils rebuild, kind of, but we're trying to make Jack Hughes the best player. So I think we'll put in Phillips, I guess. Months into the season, and the New Jersey Devils are 14-6-1. We are second in the Metro. Jesus, we are scoring a ton of goals. That's going to go down because Jack Hughes is injured. We are allowing a ton as well. The power play is clicking on all cylinders, and our penalty kill is god-awful. In 5-1, that's pretty good. Dougie Hamilton, 16 points. John Marino, 8. Siegenthaler, 6. Nemec, 5. Hagos, 5. Luke Hughes, only 2 points. That is insane. Timo Meier, Holtz, Dawson Mercer, all cooking. And then Jesper Bratt, our leading scorer. Max Pacioretty there. Heischer, Jack Hughes over a point per game. Eric Halla, what a team. It's your goalies. Cam Talbot's leading the league in wins. But I mean, yeah, these numbers are pretty, like, decent numbers for real life. We got to see the point totals, though. Adam Fox up there, Quinn Hughes. Yeah, this is pretty realistic. I mean, I can see all these guys doing well. And then Panarin with 35, Tarasenko. Maybe there should be more scoring, but there's so many more, like, more than point per game players. Holton, bro, we are getting cooked right now. Although it's not that long of an injury, so that's okay. Holton is back. We probably lost quite a few games because we had Kevin Ball running the top power play. But I mean, it's fine, you know what I'm saying? Whatever. We're now injured. We are getting hit with the injury bug hard right now, but it's fine because we got a couple players we can put in there. Nathan Bastian, welcome to the starting lineup. Our savior is back. Oh my god, it's gonna be so good to put him in the lineup again. Phillips played awful, so maybe we need more depth when it comes to the playoffs. But I mean, we're so glad to have Jack Hughes back. Your injury, Cam Talbot going down with the injury. The injuries aren't even on that high of a setting, which sucks, but yeah, we just lost our goalie, so it's Schmidt's time to be a monster like he was for a bit in real life. So yeah, Nico Daws and Schmidt are future goalies. Kind of fell off a bit when we got all these injuries, man. It's tough going through all those injuries, but here we are at January 1st, and we're somehow second in the division. Literally can't have anything good in New Jersey, bro. Luke Hughes gets injured. Wow. I'm cooked right now. What a horrible month. And the New Jersey Devils, just like real life, are selling in the second half of the season. This on forward, we're going to stack the first line completely. Hughes, Heischer, Bratt, Holtz, Halla, Meier. We need that second line center if we're going to do this. Patches, McLeod, Mercer, Bemstrom, Lazar, and Palat, because we need to get something going bad. Nico Heischer gets it. Okay, I'm actually done. I'm gonna turn this thing down. This is just annoying, boys. Like, I need to turn this down. Oh my god, bro, I pressed the wrong thing, but we're at the trade deadline, and I feel like we're gonna be buyers and sellers at the same time. Like, we're gonna sell all of these old players, all of these players that need to get rid of their contract, right? But if we have a second line center available, or like a first line winger, whatever, or whatever we need, we just need some superstar talent, more of it. Is an incredible trade for us and the Bruins, honestly. Like, 31-year-old goalie expiring for John Marino under contract. Max Pacioretty at 3 mil. Do we have to add in the third? I don't think so, but I feel like it's weird to just trade Marino and Pacioretty for Ullmark. I don't know. So I think we will add the third. We are getting fleeced, as you could see by the value. But I think Linus Ullmark, we can re-sign him. We have the money next season, especially if we get rid of Marino. And I think we're trading for a need, and we can rebuild in the free agency. So this trade will go through, and I think it is worth it. Maybe we can add a bit of draft capital in these later rounds. I mean, we are getting kind of finessed, but it's whatever. This might seem like a stupid trade, but we gotta do it, bro. We gotta get rid of Andre Palat's $6 million contract. We're getting a depth player and a bunch of depth draft picks. We're moving down by quite a bit, unfortunately, but we're gonna have to do this trade as a cap dump to make sure we're set up for the future. Is also worth it, Eric Halla. I think we're just gonna be selling this year. No need to try and like ruin the future of this team. We have a very bright future with this team, and I mean, I'm fine with going another year in this thing. The trade is Cam Talbot, who has been very good for us this year, but we just got Ullmark. We don't really need him. So we're just trying to get as many picks as possible. We don't need another pick in this draft, and I just sold. Whatever. Is it for the trade deadline? We traded for Linus Ullmark. What a trade. Nick Schmaltz for 2 second round picks. Rasmus Anderson for Philip Deneau. I was thinking of trading for Deneau, but we didn't pull the trigger. We're stacking the first line, moving Timo Meier to center. But we're going to look to pick up a second line center in free agency, or a first line left winger, and obviously move Heischer back to the second line center. Defense stays pretty much the same. And then the power play, I just went with what the coach said. I mean, we'll put Hamilton back there. Linus Ullmark, we are at the end of the year here. We did not make the playoffs. Shock. He did so bad with us. What the hell? All right, I guess our team's just trash. That honestly might be why. Like, our team is just trash. Dougie Hamilton, great season. Luke Hughes, I did expect more. Timo Meier, good season. Holtz, Mercer, could have done better. And then Jesper Bratt, almost point per game. Jack Hughes, over a point per game. Same with Nico Heischer. So that first line kind of cooked. Here are your Marc-Andre Fleury on the Toronto Maple Leafs is your win leader. I mean, pretty, like, realistic stats for goalies, because I want there to be a lot of offense, but not like too much at the same time. It's like a pretty good amount of scores here. I mean, Erik Karlsson, 92 points. He does get more than that. Why do I keep pressing right wingers here? Leon Draisaitl leads the league with 108. Yeah, okay, we need to put scoring on high, honestly. New York Islanders have won the Stanley Cup. That's interesting. Let's see how this draft lottery goes. And we are picking at 12. All right, does not want an extension, which is unfortunate, but I think we literally have to have him on this team. I don't know, do we do 4 years? Let's do 3 years. He could regress. Remember, we can only go under 1 year down, and we have to give him this because he doesn't want an extension, unfortunately. But let's get into the NHL draft and see, is there players we can trade for, or not players, what picks we can trade for? And there's unfortunately nothing. I have to trade Vilaine and 12 to move up to 10. You know, maybe get some draft capital in the later rounds for next year, like this Pittsburgh Penguins 6th, and I think that's probably it. But like, yeah, we need to move up, I think, to get good player, and we had to give up a good prospect to do that, which is unfortunate, but it's the price you pay. He's not going to be a top four defenseman, so we're going to sim to pick 10 here and see who we have. Here is your top nine. Oh my god, is it all elites? Yep, it's all elite. James Hagan and Celebrini teaming up. Pick Porter Martone is going to be our pick, I think, but we're just going to see who else we have. Oh my god, we have an elite goalie to move up to, so that's good. We have these two guys in the later rounds. Do we have any gems? We have one gem. Okay, so this could be an amazing draft if we play our cards right. but Porter Marton is going to be the first pick. This is why we moved up a 73 overall, medium elite with an X factor. That's perfect. Linus Ullmark did accept. Is it an overpay? Maybe, but you know, that's fine. But we're going to give Simone Nemec here his extension at 4.75 over 5, and hopefully that'll be a good deal for us. So we are here in free agency, and for me, it's between Mikko Rantanen, which would make our team insane, and then Nikolai Ehlers, which would also make our team insane. Obviously, Rantanen's a better player, but if we sign Ehlers, right, like we could have a way more balanced team. And but with Mikko, we'd have Mikko, Hughes, Brat, then Heischer, Meyer, and Holt as our top six, but we'd have no depth at all. So I don't know what to do, honestly. Sim a couple days, right? Let's see what we can do. Ricardo Watt signs. These AHL coaches, they don't matter, right? We need to see Simone Nemec. Has he signed the extension? Yes, he has. And then if we sim one more day, right? Let's see. Mikko Rantanen has signed to the New Jersey Devils. Oh my god, what a team this is. Here we go, season 2, Jesper Bratt with Jack Hughes and Mikko Rantanen, Timo Meier, Nico Heischer, Alex Holt, maybe the best top 6 in the NHL. The bottom 6 actually isn't bad, especially since we have a guy like Dawson Mercer, who could be a trade asset, you never know. And then our top 4 on defense, Luke Hughes went down for some reason, but he'll be back up. I'm pretty confident he will be. And then we have Hagos right here, who could move into Siegenthaler's role pretty soon. And then, of course, we got Ullmark between the pipes. And then here's the power play. Absolutely nasty. On December 1st, and we are 10-10-1, which is very interesting. Let's see the plus minus of the boys. Why is this first line minus? What the hell is going on? EA, why is my first line, one of the best lines in all of hockey, doing so bad? Jesus Christ, our third pair is bad. McKinnon, Kyle Connor, I mean, look at this, bro. Why aren't we getting this type of scoring? We have one of the best first lines in hockey. Why is scoring down when we put scoring up? I don't know, man. Where he wasn't great either, which is annoying, man. Let's see how the boys are doing. I mean, I don't even know why this team, like, why aren't we getting more scoring from that first line? Is it the power play? Because, like, maybe they're just not putting up power play points. But yeah, we're one of the lowest scoring teams. We're pretty mid in goals, and then yeah, the power play isn't doing that good. Neither is the penalty kill. Damn, Ullmark doing so bad. Is the defense in front of him just the worst? Because, like, I'm just looking for a 900 save percentage with this. It's so high. Maybe it's just the attribute effects that I have to tune up. Honestly, I got no clue what's going on. Oh my god, just as everything is going good, Jack Hughes gets injured, and that potentially could be our season. Maybe, who knows? Oh, Rantanen is injured as well. Like, what is this, boys? Come on, EA. Why is Mikko Rantanen and Jack Hughes injured? They're purposely selling us. It's gotta be a joke. This has got to be the biggest joke. EA is tickling the tip of my pickle right now. What is going on? Nico Heischer's also injured. Like, honestly, scrap the whole video. Like, at this point, look at that. Going into the trade deadline, I think we're, because of all the injuries, we have to be a conservative buyer. It sucks. But this is the dumbest thing ever. How are we getting injured so much? I don't even know who, like, would help our team other than just a bunch of, like, 1 year depth, like, because we have no cap space as well. I think we're gonna try and dump off these 1 year deals to start the deadline, and then maybe use all these picks to go in for a player, maybe. So that seems like the good move. got Jordan Eberle, so that's perfect as a playmaking replacement for Lazat. I mean, we're not going to re-sign him, but he brings playoff experience, and apparently we got fleeced by the trade finder, alright. You gotta be capping, bro. Fuck you, EA, bro. What the hell is this? Doggy Hamilton, our four best players. Literally, look at our injury list, bro. That's like all of our all-star players just getting absolutely cooked for no reason, bro. What the hell is this? Now we have to put Timo Meier as our extra attacker. Dude, we literally could have made the playoffs. If you guys want me to turn off injuries, because this will probably be the last episode for now. If you guys want me to turn off injuries after this season, let me know, because that would make it maybe easier to get to the playoffs. Came through clutch when we needed it most, and we are so close to making our first playoffs, which I guess would be in the next episode. The video is so long already, might be the longest video we've ever had on the channel, but let's see if the boys can come through. And Jack Hughes, the star of this series, has become... What am I saying? Oh my god, you gotta be kidding me. You gotta be fucking... Just sold our entire season. Dougie Hamilton just got injured for the rest of the season, and he's not coming back even if we make the finals. So this team has to rally back, and we win against Connor Bedard 6-0. We clinch if we win this next game. I don't know the math on it, but it's against our oh my god, Emil Bemström, our old player. But the comeback is on. Two power play goals by the boys, 6-6, and we're going to a shootout, and we get at least 1 point. Can we keep this streak up heading into the playoffs? Let's see how we do against Philadelphia Flyers. Tied 1-1, Michkov and Dawson Mercer, and they go up 5-1. Jesus Christ. We cannot sell right now. Come on, boys. Please get this win. No, Mike Hoffman. Why? Oh my god, we just glossed, bro. We're actually about to blow the playoffs. We just have to win two of these next three games. Oh my god, come on. Dude, if we miss the playoffs, it would be so heartbreaking. It would just be because of Dougie Hamilton missing and Panarin. And oh my god, we had a comeback. Holt, Meyer, Rantanen. Come on, boys. x8 simulation. This is how we're going to be playing in the playoffs. This is a big test. If we make it, if we don't make it, honestly, we should just scrap the entire series. We're going to keep going because this is fun. 5 minutes. Come on, boy. You know what? Just skip. Yeah, and we lost. Great. We missed the playoffs, I think. So let's just simulate till the end. And we lost to Carolina and lost. We threw that. We actually fucking threw that because of Dougie fucking Hamilton. Fuck. That's GG's, boys. See ya, boy.